Okay, so today we're going to finish up the last part of this little series that we've been working on. We're going to swap out diff fluid and front diff of the Maxx. So let's start getting her apart. Let's get this front bumper out of the way. Okay. There's your front bumper. I'm not going to cut the wires. I'm not going to cut the zip ties. Now, this is going to be hard for y'all to see, but there's actually some bolts down in here that we've got to take out to get to this lower bulkhead out. We're going to take out one here. This. Yeah, I've got to get me some new tips, folks. Let's see if the ball tip will grab it. Two other ones in here that I'm told we have to take out that are down inside here to get this thing out. I'm gonna try to put me some light down in here because I can't even see these myself. There's one right here. Little flat screw. Up here on the subject. And now let's flip her over. All right. Now, let's not use any of our screws today. How about that? Out. these two off here. Our front diff, and once again we can see where the bearings are sealing, where they're not sealing, where dirt's getting. Everything looks pretty good so far, so let's roll the diff out. I'm gonna slide the axles off of it, set it down. I don't see any. We're gonna pull this out. I'm gonna clean these bearings up a little bit, but actually I'm just gonna wipe some of the dirt off and we're gonna put these back in, so. Dirt out of that channel there. And let's just put these back where they go, because that is okay for today. Slide this back. Let's get this where you guys can see it better. Alright, so now let's pull our once again. I mean, everything looks good. A little bit of grease is all, you know, on these things. Just like the rear, you got a smaller bearing on one side, bigger bearing on the other side. All we're gonna do is pull the axle off this side so we can access the diff in here. Pull this out with power, but I will definitely put it back in with by hand. Alright, so we'll put that off. Get the bearing off. Wipe some of the dirt off of it. Bearing feels fine. Alright, so let's pull this thing apart. My guess is right. There isn't hardly any fluid in here. And we can just top it off. Stay in there, you stay in there. So here we go. Moment of truth. And my guess is right. There's hardly anything in here. So here's what we're going to do. We're just going to top this off with some 200. And then we're going to put it all back together again. Y'all want to see some goopy stuff. Watch this. It doesn't even want to come. You can't really see, but pretty much just pack the stuff in here. It's so thick. Add a little bit more to her. Come on, get off her. Back and forth a little bit here. All right. Let's stick her back together. I didn't even snug that one up. I just got it started. I did that because it was stuck in the bit. All down a little bit. This one. This is a messy job. See all that squeezed out of there. Some of you may ask. Okay. So, this happens from time to time. She is completely locked up. So, we're going to take her back apart and find out why. More than likely, one of the gears is not, has come out of place. Spinning now, but everything looks like it's in place. Tighten up a couple of these screws and see what happens. Something's not right. Likely one of the shafts is turned in here and it's not sitting where it's supposed to. Okay. So what we're gonna end up doing is pulling these out and making sure shafts are sitting where they're supposed to be. some fluid in it. Let's try her again. Mo better, mo better. Stiff, but not locked. She spins. All right, let's put a bearing back on. Line our axle back up. Now, get some grease around this thing. to cut this tube so I can get down in it. And again, some people are going to say, you don't put enough grease. Some people are going to say, I put too much grease. Like I've said before, matter of opinion, to each their own, do whatever works for you. Number four, I told you there was ones on the Maxx are keyed. Which is right there. Okay, a little bit. And we can put our 4 bolts back in. those of y'all that are curious, I'm going to be ordering my MIP bits today. Back on. Now we can go ahead and put this center cover back in. Since we're both done with the front and the rear. Aha! Notice, notches. This thing only fits one way. Of course, duh. You got a hole there for the motor screw, so that ought to be a pretty good giveaway itself. So I asked James, I mean, I know changing this rear diff fluid is going to make it handle a little better, but he really hasn't had any issues with it handling. I asked him about the Wide Max kit because I know I'm going to get questioned about that. If you want to make it handle better, put the Wide Max kit on it. He's really not interested in doing it. He likes the way it drives. This is his truck, so we will leave it like it is, just change the fluid out. And if it comes to the point where he doesn't like the way it handles now, I'll go back and change all the fluids back. So we're all back together. And all James has to do at this point is change the shop fluid, because I am going to let him do that part. Put this thing up on his stand. It actually works pretty good when the tires ain't on it. When the tires are on it, yeah. It keeps them off the ground a little bit where you can turn it around, but it ain't very much off the ground. I can guarantee you that. So, final thoughts. This thing is pretty easy to work on. Just like the Max, or the X Max, I should say. Gotta say X Max now, because now that you know, you gotta put that X in front of there so people know which one you're talking about. But it is fairly easy to work on. I like the way Traxxas made it modular. I really like the fact that most of the screws, when you take the modules apart, are all the same size. This thing, if you've watched my other videos, you will see that James has put this thing through hell. And so far, we've only broken a caster block on that side. And a... now the chassis. So, and I think chassis, if I'd have put heavier shock oil in it to start with, I think we'd have saved that chassis. I think that chassis snapped due to us in the ground too much on this thing, of him slapping the concrete with it too much. So I think putting heavier shock oil in it's going to help that. Anyway, if anybody has any questions, comments, leave them down below. And as always, keep on bashing.